I was raised in a small town, in a small Methodist church, and we'd go regularly. But instead of telling us how to get to heaven, they would focus on hell and make us feel guilty. So I promised myself that when I got out on my own, I would not go to church anymore. And that's exactly what I did. Went to college, got a job in Memphis, never went to church. But I had a girlfriend that I worked with, and we go to lunch every now and then. And she would talk to me about Jesus Christ and Christianity. And I mean, the first time she talked to me about it, I told her, if being a Christian means going to church, I am not interested. And she said, well, you don't have to go to church to get to heaven. I'm like, okay, I can keep talking to you now. But she kept on and on inviting me to church. Well, I finally said, okay, I'll go to church with you. I knew Bellevue was a big church because I'd seen it on TV. But what did surprise me was when Dr. Rogers got up on the podium, he said, now take your Bible and turn to whatever. And I was looking around, we were in the balcony, I was looking around, everybody had a Bible and a notebook, and they were just taking notes. Of course, I didn't have a Bible. But I'm like, okay, this guy is fixing to tell me and explain this book to me. So I'm like, well, this isn't like church. It's like a school. I'm like, okay, I can come back and do this. I did regularly go to Bellevue, but there were some things that were said and sung or whatever that I didn't get. Phrases, words, whatever. And so the week that I would think about that, Dr. Rogers would explain what that was. And the first time that happened, I thought, well, what a coincidence. I was just wondering about that this week. But the third and fourth time that happened, I'm like, no, this is not a coincidence. God's talking to me through Dr. Rogers. So I accepted Jesus Christ as my Lord and Savior, March 21st, 1982.
This is my story. This is my song. Praising my Savior all the day long.